I'm Katie, and tonight is the start of hopefully a long-running stream format that I'm calling Press Any Key, wherein we look at the weird, the unseen, the bad, and hopefully some of the good games that are out there on the internet. See, I got my my skull here, who seems to be asking, who seems to be saying, I heard you talking shit. Hi, Xenon. Hi, Lisa. Hi, Bad Road. Hi, Christy. Everyone, welcome to the stream. Let's get weird. So, I guess the first game... Now, all these, except for one, were found by my wife, Christy, in the chat. And I'm going in blind on all but one of these. And I don't know if we'll get to them all tonight, but I'm going to try to spend a little bit of time with each one. So I don't know if there's any particular order I should be playing these in. She didn't number them, so I'm assuming it's okay. Yeah, I don't know who drew this skull. I wish I could credit them, because it's real nice. It actually could just be a photograph with a bunch of filters over it, now that I look at it, because I think that's the sketchy pencil G-mic filter that's going over it, so it could just be that. Regardless, I wish I knew who made it. Alright, I've been told I should start with Coffin Counseling. So, let me find that... I don't see Coffin Counseling. There it is. Internet link to Coffin Counseling. Okay. Okay, let's do that then. God damn it. Of course. Okay. So, the way I have Firefox set up, I'll just open a different profile. That's fine. She won't mind. Here we go. Make sure that all looks okay. There's just a big gray square. Is that normal? Because it doesn't look like that's how it's... Oh, there it goes. Oh, God. Oh, God. It's an embedded Unity app. Up is down and ugly is beautiful. Also, we do not have desktop sound because, of course, we don't... there we go. Speakers. Perfect. Also, when I haven't clicked on the Unity app, it sound stops, which is kind of weird for an embedded one. Move with WASD or arrows, interact with the spacebar. Alright. That's kind of weird to have this embedded. How's the sound balance for everyone? Let me turn it down from my speaker so it doesn't come through my mic, too. Does this sound good to everyone? Excellent. All right, let's rock. I'm an adorable bat. W switches whether I'm on the ceiling or floor. Left and right move. Hey you, Lord Dracula's feeling depressed. And H, is there any way that I can, like, make this? Okay, I can just zoom in the browser. That's better. All right, this should do it. Move that slightly. There we go. Lord Dracula is feeling depressed and ate his therapist. Ow. Now everyone's feeling down and nobody is terrorizing the country. You were chosen as a new therapist for the Lord. Get on it. Oh, so it's a bat who's a therapist. This sounds familiar. Alright, and stand there, and it's skipping really, really bad when I'm moving left and right, so that's a shame. Okay, I got that. I thought spacebar was supposed to interact. Oh, apparently spacebar and W are the same. Oh my god, I am so depressed, I just cannot take it. Compliment flexibility. You think so? I don't feel very flexible anymore. I just wish there was more to life than work. Hobbies. You're right. I always wanted to try emasculation. Thanks. I feel better now. I guess I helped someone, question mark. So this is basically just a game about me. And it controls like vvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvvv Jesus, I'm already having a hard time figuring out where I am, and I've only gone a few steps. I'm a game developer, but I think my game is going to be shit. Game's content? It's random encounters with weird people to solve their problems. Of course it is. Should I even try to finish this? Is it worth the time? Experience and joy. You are right. I don't want my work to disappear in a drawer. Time to get back to work and finish this. See, I'm a great bat therapist. Yeah, it controls exactly like Vuv. Come and see a most terrifying creature from the depths of the woods. Terror beyond compare. Alright, you don't need help. It's just a rabbit. I ate too much, but I still feel empty inside. It ate that skeleton's skin. I do this for every meal. I just sort of lose track of how much I've already eaten and hate myself afterwards. Am I overeating to forget my worries, or is the food just really, really good? I also really wish that guy over there would stop calling me a terror beyond compare. Rude. The rabbit just needed to talk. Come and see a most terrifying creature from the depths of the woods. Terror beyond... Oh, I can't tell him to knock that shit off. That is hurting her feelings. Excuse me, I'm trying to do a thing here. Could you please leave? Aww. Hey, that werewolf's wearing shorts. I love that you call it Vuv. I mean, it's either that or the official VVVVV/WWW. Bat therapist would make a great alternate universe Bruce Wayne. I can't disagree. Woof. Woof woof. Yeah, I know that feeling. We are very close to a major scientific breakthrough. You are delaying science by wasting our time. Please don't talk to me or my brothers ever again. It's the meme. Guess we're just supposed to wander around till we find Dracula. Hello. I don't know if I want to go. Huh? Don't make fun of me. No thanks. Allergic to blood. Never mind. Nods. Sigh. I don't think I helped that one. Oh, thanks. Cough. Sigh. Oh, yes. Never mind. I think I'm just supposed to dot 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 at him. Monologue about Kafka. Is that a furry? Probably. Oh, yes. Thanks for spending time with me. Aww. That's so cute.
Hey, you. Yes, you. Would you come here? Don't be afraid. My bark is worse than my bite. I just want to talk. I'm selling stuff out of my trunk, but I don't earn much, so maybe I'll have to branch out a bit more. You have any ideas? Because I'm stumped. Let me check my log. So far, I sold stem cells, stalks, and I had wood, but that didn't go well. Wait, why are you leaving? Is it late? Oh, wood nights.
I'm planning to leaf my partner. We've been living together in this room for too long. I just can't take the puns anymore. I used to love him for his hard wood, but he can't say a single sentence without breaking out some wordplay. It's killing me inside. I just can't bear it. Christ, you two are made for each other. Oh, no, stop. Stop! There's no way to skip it. Oh god. It's a new form of torture. Alright. Hey, it's King Slime, except with horns. My skeleton boyfriend has trouble getting a boner. What can I do? How about lingerie? Teehee, blushes. That should give him a nice osseous solidification. Thanks. So this is just a game about puns, really. Nobody follows me on Splatter. I don't want to be unpopular. Post werewolf pics, post witty banter, post personal torment. Post werewolf pics. Everyone loves the fuzzy furry ones. Yes, would you follow me on Splatter? Of course. Awesome, you are my 7th follower. I'll be so popular now. Awesome. I can't stop watching Netflix. Please help me. Wait, no, don't turn off the TV just yet. Where's Dracula? Oh, I found him. Oh my god, he's adorable. Oh, it's you. You're the new therapist, right? I am Lord Dracula. Fear me. It's just not the same anymore. I used to fill people with dread just by thinking about their mothers, but these days nothing seems to scare people anymore. Everyone is so busy with the economy or whatever, they don't even notice when you swoop in to steal their souls. Afterwards, they post a pic of the bite marks on social media and get more likes than I do. I don't even care about that stuff. But somehow it feels like they accomplished more than I did in my 1,000-year reign of terror. I built this business with my own claws, you know? When I started out, no one was terrorizing peasants like I did. Even when they sent mobs to burn me, I didn't give up. Yes, I never gave up, and I won't give up now just because times are grim. With 2 M's. I'll teach people what it means to be truly scared. Hi, Alma. They'll laugh in the face of the work deadlines and social anxiety when I am done with them. I cried the whole night when I should have been out there haunting the nightmares of mortals. I will go and strike fear into their hearts. Yes, thank you, small bat. Nice tie, by the way. You truly helped me to understand myself. Now to... Wait, is that the... Thanks for playing. Ah, that was good. That was cute. So here's the credits. If you want to find it, it's at rose-engine.itch.io/manbat. If you want to give that a look and explore around more than I did. That was cute. So that's a good way to start us off. I can't believe the stream's over now. Well, don't you worry. Because up next, we have Davey Bones Spooky Jaunt. Sounds legit. Hopefully it doesn't start up in full screen and screw everything up. Because for real, if your game starts in full screen, you really need to match the size of the screen. Alright, oh, this one can use the controller. Alright. Let's game capture this one. Capture specific window. Davey Bones Spooky Jaunt. Is that correct? Yes. Now I need to... It is not showing up, though, which is weird. Just a second. Let's remove that one. Capture it here. Davey Bones Spooky Jaunt. Still not showing for some reason. This one does not like game capture. Yes, it's above the other one. Okay. Sec, let's hit transform. Oh, I see what the problem is. I don't know why it did that. All right, it needs to be no, it still didn't work. All right, so this one just doesn't like... Yeah, this one does not like game capture. So let's try window capture. Hey, that works. Window capture tends to be more reliable, so... Now let's stretch that out a bit. All right, that looks pretty good. Davey Bones is his spooky jaunt. Actually, I might be able to hit maximize. Yeah, that would have actually been a lot easier, huh? There, now we've got Davey Bones' Spooky Jaunt. Alright? Looks good. Let's start it. Well, let's hit how to play. I can't choose. Oh, there it goes. Oh, this is cute. I like this style. Can only use the D-pad. It won't let me use the joystick. That's very uncomfortable for my arthritic thumbs. A to jump. Collect coins and gems for points. Oh god. X to dash. Haha. Ah, fuck. Haha. I am the best. Oh, come on. I was holding up. Ugh. It really does not like you turning around and then air dash, or and then dashing upwards. So I'm not sure what to make of that. Yeah, it's having a very hard time registering that on this D-pad. Very hard time, and I don't like that. I may have to use keyboard controls. They might be a little easier. I'm multiplier, dash to increase score multiplier, stay in the air. Yeah, that's gonna be impossible with these controls. Because of that shit. This does not like this D-pad at all. Alright. Oh. Select level. And are you seriously gonna make me exit the whole game to switch control type? You are. That's amazing. Alright. Let's try this again. WASD K and L. That's not great. But could be worse. Oh, I guess we're starting level 1. Oh god. Okay, this isn't so bad. Oh, this is cute. Max airtime. Well, I got the D. Level 2. This resembles that game Andy was playing a while ago. Which one? Oh my god. Yeah, it's still having a hard time registering the up and dash at the same time, and I've got a keyboard with individual switches. Or WASD and D, so it's not a conflict. Alright, there we go. I'm starting to get it. We have to be really... not precise? You have to be... there's a specific way you have to push it for it to register, and it's hard to explain. Party is this way. Oh crap, that hurt. Oh fuck. Dead skeleton. Don't tell me most skeletons are dead, because that's not cool. Don't judge the skeletons like that. Hey, I found a quicker way, or longer way. Yeah, this is much better on the keyboard than the controller, which is weird for a platform game. Party this way. Jaunt sisters. Yeah, it's kind of a similar mechanic. Oh, crap. Oh, come on. Party this way. also a heart. Yep, I thought so. I'm good at finding secrets in games. I got a costume bit. Hooray! Now I'm a skeleton dressed as a mummy, kind of. I'm guessing there's one in each level. Ow. Oh, fuck. Alright, I'm gonna give this one more try before we move on to the next one. This is cute. Not giving me much to say. It's a cute little platformer. Ah, fuck. Which I am not very good at. Oh god. Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do here. Well, that didn't lead anywhere. Did you try the keyboard? Because it sucked on the controller. Oh god. Hey, we made it. And I guess, since we're here, we may as well check out the party. Also, apparently the costume, judging from the icons there, is a mummy witch bat. Which, honestly, I should dress as that. Oh, look how cute. I can see you tried. Go inside and enjoy the fun. But it seems Mummy Girl ain't all that impressed. Look again, look harder, look to win. Nah, that's okay. That's a cute little game. That was Davey Bones Spooky Jaunt, for anyone who wants to check it out and look a little further. Well, I guess that was okay. Certainly worth a few minutes of your time. So now let's try Fastest Skeleton. I think I know what Fastest Skeleton is. I think I've seen it before. Oh, this one does not have a maximize button. Oh god. Yes, I do believe I know what this is. Move skeleton with arrow keys, restart with R. Apply. Maximized, sure. Alright, good. So here we are. We are a skeleton. And we are beautiful. Oh, look at that groin thrust. Why didn't you just close the window? Oh, God. I didn't even mean to go through the door, that's why. So I think we're the fastest skeleton now. With a vibrating erection. So, let's try that again, this time without hitting the fake quit button. Did we get to the party? My power keeps flickering. Oh, that's too bad. We did get to the party, and they were like, "Aw, you tried. Isn't that adorable?" Alright. Now, as you can see, I've got Mastodon stuff popping up. So, hi, Andy, if you're watching. Now we just go to start. Oh yeah, shake that booty. All right, let's go fast. Oh God, my foot's stuck. You know how physics engines are mostly nowadays used to just make fun of how bad physics engines are? I think that's what we're seeing right now. I'm stuck. This is beautiful. As is its protagonist, the fastest skeleton. Aw yeah, let's go. And we are losing signal. I'm gonna wait for that to end. Yeah, that was a good 750-odd frames. Sorry about that. No. Nope. They are conspiring to fuck me. Alright, let's wait just a sec and see if it stays stable. Alright. That is our ISP as usual. This game is very spoopy. So did Quap die and this is his skeleton? I think so, yes. I think that's exactly what's going on here. I think we have discovered the hidden lore. The hidden lore of Quap. You know, he released that other game, Getting Over It, aka Quap 2, Son of Quap. That guy's mother was, just a cauldron and a sledgehammer glued together. Oh man, this is the best game ever. Look at this shit. No, now you're stuck again, skeleton. No, you're gonna... Alright, now we gotta slither. You kind of slither hop. That's the best way I can describe how moving in this feels. A lot more slithery than it might look. Uh-oh. My foot's stuck. It's okay. It's okay. We have achieved nirvana. Yes! I exist everywhere. Oh. I did exist everywhere. Oh my god. Oh my god. I am a god. My leg exists within its own personal world. Also, I just realized that technically the part that I'm controlling is the groin. Uh-oh. Nope, nope, I'm fucked. I don't think I'm going to be able to get up there without managing to snap off my leg. Nope. Climb the wall. Yes! Oh my god, I'm amazing. Who's the fastest skeleton now, jerk? You must ascend! Ascend, little skeleton! Yes! Nope, nope. Come on. We can do this. Yes! I am the fastest skeleton! And my leg is still stuck in the level somehow. So what's gonna happen if I fall off? Is my leg gonna get stuck? Yes, and in fact I can continue to use it to jump. Yeah, I'm just gonna hang out here for a while.
Arise, skeleton, arise.
So that was maybe the greatest game ever created. Well, what should we do next? How about, let's start here at the bottom with the hair in the wall. Load, oh, that's a good sign. I remember those loading bars. Oh god, full screen. Oh god, it just fucked everything. Okay, I can't, do anything. Just a sec. Alright, now I can see that again. I'm trying to rearrange my windows now because, of course, they all got moved to different monitors. Fuck. I need to be able to see the chat. This isn't cool. Alright, I can see the chat again. Oh, I hate that. Alright, let's see what happens. And it's up in the upper left corner. So, I guess what we're gonna do is hit game capture and see if I can grab it this way. Is that gonna work? It is not. These do not like game capture. Alright, let's try window capture, which usually doesn't work on full screen stuff. Window capture. On the hair in the wall. Alright, that one seems to have worked. Alright, now, you guys are also going to see some of it in the upper left because I'm keeping the monitor capture on too. Good stuff right here. You've just moved in. New house, new job, new life. While you were mounting some shelves, you noticed something down in the basement. A hair in the wall. Okay. There, I picked it. You pulled it off. Now let's go to bed. So that the house is just gonna keep growing hair, right? Your neighbors are coming to welcome you. Let's pour some wine. Maybe there's still a bottle in the basement. It's there again. You know you want to. Go on, pull it off. Okay. And hi, Andy, if you didn't hear me say it the first time. I think I might have said it before you actually got here, because I saw your notification. Last night was rough. You couldn't get no sleep. Why, that hair was still there. You are sure to have pulled it off the day before. Now there is no time to think about it. You have to go to work, and you are getting late. Why is the grammar getting worse? You saw it, didn't you? Yeah, you didn't have to inform me. Since the day of the welcome party, you no longer went down to the basement. What if it is there again? In that case, let's end this once and for all. Scrap it off. Okay, take a butter knife. Down to the basement one last time. It's no use. It doesn't come off. You need a powerful tool. What the fuck is this? You're in a hardware store. You don't recall if you slept, eaten, or went to work. All you know is that you've to get rid of that hair in the wall. Alright, let's get the most expensive one. Yeah, I know. I scrapped it off on their wall.
It was pretty expensive, but it will solve your problem, all your problems. Your trusty flashlight is upstairs. The truth is near. What? The wall closed up again. Come on now. There was a hole here. It's gone now. Oh, wow! Referencing a better game. You got the best sleep of your entire life. The hair is vanished. The hole was never there. You are safe now, finally. I'm not sure if this is taking the piss. I want to believe it is. Mom says it's my turn to pull the hair. Oh no, the bloods. You've never moved in. This is your old house, your old job, your old life. And that was your dead wife. What the fuck did I just play? What the fuck was that? Oh my god. Oh, whoops. So yeah, that's how it rearranges windows and shit. Say hi to recursion forever. There we go. That was so scary, wasn't it, everyone? Okay. Alright, let's try Skullhammer. That sounds way better. Hey, full screen window mode. Thank you. People need to use this shit. It's so much nicer. Special thanks to Bullethead for a beautiful graphics and cooperation. Thank you for the clip. Oh, okay, not mouse controlled. Controller support? No, just keyboard. Arrow keys. What do I press? Space. Hey, you! Skeleton, wake up! You're lucky that they didn't chain ya. That dungeon is haunted. You have to escape. Move your character by the arrows. Use space bar to jump. Alright. Looks like it's gonna be a maze game. Can I jump on things? Nope. We're going this way. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. Press down arrow to pick up or drop this hammer. Use control key to use it. These are not good control bindings. At all. Oh god, I can barely hurt him. You are dead. I mean, you lose. Alright, let's try that again, knowing that that hammer doesn't do shit. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to jump that, but it looks like the other door will just lead to the other side. Yes, I was correct. Hooray! What? Okay. Control has stopped working. Oh, it doesn't work if the hammer would land on air, which seems like kind of a oversight, I guess. Do you see that trigger? Press it using your hammer. By pressing triggers, you can get access to new rooms. Oh, I thought that was another button. Okay. What am I supposed to do there? Oh god. Okay, why was it hurting him more now? I don't like that. As expected, it's a maze game. Also, I'm not sure what standing on these does, but apparently that does something. Okay, there's something in the background. Y'all see that? Yeah, I don't know what standing on these is doing. Can I leave my hammer on them? Oh, I can. I don't know what good that does either. That's interesting. Now I guess I see what the point of dropping the hammer is. I keep thinking that up is gonna be jump. This is really kind of hurting my hand. Watch out. There is a big danger. Unfortunately, I cannot help you since I'm hanging here. Anyway, good luck. Oh man, that sucks when I'm hanging here. Alright, so I guess I gotta leave that hammer behind. I thought his health bar was a platform. You successfully escaped. I'm so proud of you. Unfortunately, I am still imprisoned. I mean, you seem to be able to move around pretty well. Well then, have a nice day. You win. Oh, I thought I'd be able to get that other larger hammer. You won. You escaped from the dungeon. So I think there's probably another ending to that. Yeah, that's cute. That's a cute little game. That might be worth your time if you want to see what the other ending is. What was that called? That was called Skullhammer. Don't know where to get it. It'll probably show up on itch.io if you search for Skullhammer. Yeah, that's not bad. The skeleton is coming from inside the dungeon. I knew it. Alright, let's try Midnight Scenes. No, let's try Skeleghost. I love these ones that are just an executable. Alright, Skeleghost doesn't seem to be starting. Oh, no, it just took forever. Oh, that's gorgeous. I love that. It's like winning a game of solitaire in Windows. What? Okay. Oh, this one's a winner. This one's a real winner. Can already tell. Alright, let's switch window capture over to it. It does not... Oh, there it is. Alright. There we go. Looks pretty good. What do you mean spacebar changes you? Spacebar isn't doing nothing. Huh. I thought that was on the title screen for some reason.
Oh, C.
C doesn't do anything either. Oh, Z. There we go. Z. Oh, now I'm a ghost. Oh, I can only move in the yellow as... No? There doesn't seem to be any rhyme or reason as to what I can and can't do as the ghost. Okay. I'm
I'm a little bewildered. There doesn't seem to be any particular rules about what I can and can't do as the ghost. I think they kind of look like parrots. Yeah, the ghost just can go through some stuff and not other stuff, and there doesn't seem to be any rhyme or reason to it. See, I can't go down here, but I can go through this part. I can also go through the enemies. Huh. What am I... So what, I'm just supposed to push up against all the invisible walls, I guess. Oh, I see. Interesting. Huh. What? I switched to ghost and it just teleported me. Cute. Doesn't matter though, because I can just go right through them. Huh. This is kind of an interesting idea of a mechanic, but I'm not sure it's executed remotely competently. Like, there's no challenge to the puzzles, except that sometimes you just kind of have to... And that's it. I guess it's kind of like a demo for the idea of the mechanic. It wasn't abysmal. It just wasn't good. That was strictly middle of the road. Also, I'm certain that that's some licensed song slowed way down. I'm almost certain of that. So do you think the middle part of that E, once it's gonna continue to zoom in until it engulfs the whole screen? Gonna get weird, everyone. You were warned. Think I can just leave this going indefinitely and get millions of views? Just keeps going. I'm impressed. Enough of that. All right. Let's take a look at... These are going by much quicker than I expected. All right, let's take a look at Midnight Scenes. All right, let's dump that to 1600 by 900 in a window. Fantastic quality. And window capture, Midnight Scenes. Hey, it works. Switch transformation. Where is it? Transform. Reset transformation. There we go. Power flickered again. Did we ever figure out if those were penguins or kappas? They were Bulbasaurs. I think they were parrots. Midnight Scenes. Well, it's gotta be better than the hair in the wall. Yeah, usually I'm pretty good at telling if something's taking the piss, but with that one, I honestly couldn't. It seemed so sincere in a way. Claire Barnes, age 29. She's about to discover what kind of horrors lurk in the darkness of a deserted road. Wait, it's black and white. Let me get this right. Claire Barnes, age 29. She's about to discover what kind of horrors lurk in the darkness of a deserted road. A flat tire delayed Claire's trip. Little she suspects how this little incident will change her life forever, as well as her perception of reality. Oh, I turned off the radio. Okay, well, this is stylish as fuck. Tonight's episode, The Highway! Nyeh! You think they were going for more Rod Sterling? Oh, I'm going with The Strong Dad. The sneak, fetch my circuitry! An unexpected obstacle, a new delay for Claire. She might need to find some help to resume her journey as soon as possible. Fortunately, she notices a signal, pointing to a near emergency phone. Let's wish her luck! Yeah, that's... She's dead, right? What I just did? She's dead. Straight up. Alrighty. So there's a blood-faced killer on the loose. Ooh, that's pretty scary. Can we just leave? That seems like the sensible thing to do. Oh, look, he's not a blood-faced killer after all. He's just a normal child. What's this one say? Oh, look, he's just a normal child. That's as far that way as we can go. Oh, alright. That's... Why does clicking there... It's fine. Oh, wow. Someone died in a car crash and they just happened to leave this Polaroid of their family behind. It's not a Polaroid, it doesn't have the grippy part. A photograph. Yes, he's a normal-faced killer, possibly a baby-faced killer. Yes, blood-faced killer, like from the Yutang... The Wu-Tang Clan. Oh, look, there's the blood-faced killer. And there is a woman with a beak. And also a man with blood for an arm. I'm making fun. I'm being harsh. This doesn't deserve what I'm doing to her right now. This is cute so far. Why can't I use the hammer on the lock? Because it's an adventure game? Oh, right. Where would the key to the chain be? Here's a mechanical scarecrow and a pie chart? And here is a drawing of a farmer and a child. Here's the mechanical scarecrow. Now, where's the pie chart? Should be right over here, right? Alright, we've got part of a broom. Can we attach it to the scarecrow? We can't. Can we hit the scarecrow with a hammer? What? She tried to. That's the first time she's tried to do anything. But now she's not with the broom, though. With the broom, she doesn't give a fuck. Huh. This game's a little inconsistent. Where's the key to the lock? That is the question. I can't look up at where the key would go for the ignition. If I only had a brain, would a mechanical scarecrow just be a tin man? You'd think so. But there's a distinction. Can I hit the steering? No. Can I hit the photo? No. Can I sweep up the glass? No. I don't see anything else to do back here. Can't get into the gas tank. Can't take the shovel. Can't do anything with the lock. This. Oh. Options! Alright, that's fine. Not a lot of options. Let's see. We've got some tools now, and we've only got two screens to explore. Can I hit someone with a hammer? Let's sabotage our own car now. Any suggestions from the audience? I don't see anything else to do that we haven't already. There's lots of interactive things, but our items don't work with any of them. Was that the arm for the scarecrow by the back of the wrecked car? Let's find out. I did not even... Oh, by the back of the wrecked truck. Because the car isn't wrecked. I don't know what you're referring to. But no. There's just a trail of blood and this poster box. I really just want to attach this broom to the scarecrow. Oh hey, I can lift the scarecrow's arm? I don't know what good that does. Oh. What? Why did I... Huh? Oh, I bet it had to do with that diagram, huh? Yeah, because it's mechanical. Even so, it should have attached just fine. Weird. Okay. I can... Now it's allowing me to attach the broom, regardless. This puzzle doesn't make sense to me. Need a key to get to the bolt cutters, yes. Yes, we need the bolt cutters so we can cut the chain so we can get the bolt cutters, exactly. Oh, here we go. Now it's tied on. Now hit it with a hammer. Still doesn't make sense. Oh, okay. That still doesn't make sense, you know, in the broader sense of things making sense. Hey, look, the TV's on. I guess he just limped inside and slumped down on the couch. Prepare for jump scares, everyone. Hey, it's that picture. You know, of the farmers. Parodied everywhere. I don't remember what it's called. Okay, apparently it's not the TV making that's causing the flickering. And now he's not gonna be there if the light comes back on, right? No, she just doesn't want to go in. Can I hit the corpse? No. What's the hammer for? I want to hit someone, thing. Now we're in the backyard. I found a hole. Guys, I found a hole. American Gothic, yes, thank you, both of you. Alright, I took the hole. Here's a horseshoe that's probably part of a gravestone. Yep, just gonna steal a nail for reasons. Yeah, that's not gonna get us into trouble later. Why is she comfortable just going through this fucking house and stealing shit? I have no sense for who this woman is, except that she's kind of an asshole. There we go. Ah, here we go. Why did that use up the hammer? Horse grave. Yeah, looks like it. Because it's an adventure game, because she's white. If she is dead, it's not like they can arrest her for stealing. All believable stories. A wrecked treehouse. Now I can take the lantern. I can't light it, though, so... On the TV. Oh, the lantern just works. You can't tell me you didn't see him the first time you were in here. You did have like a full couple seconds. Alright, now we're just gonna loot the corpse. Oh, there's the key. Wow, she is really determined to get her car through here. You're not gonna take the lantern? Lots of beer bottles. I guess he's been drinking because his son's missing. His whole shit is fucked up. You are such a master of prose, Lisa. You know, I'd be taking the pickaxe and the shovel, personally. Hooray! Now what, we just walk through? Yeah, to get to the emergency phone. The end. That's the end of the game, right there. Oh look, everybody died. Just a trail of corpses. Well, time to steal shit. Alright, there's a map on this clipboard. There's a photo on this clipboard. It appears to be of someone just drawing on the wall in blood with some other corpses there. They are small enough to be a child. Here is a child with shit hooked up to his brain. There's the poster again. 999. Not gonna outright actually have to pick up. I can't dial 9. Not letting me dial at all, in fact. There's a ringtone, but it's not letting me dial. That's weird. Hey, Riz, good to see you. Hey, look, it's a child. Sup, child? Oh, look, she got shocked by him. Here he is with a horse. The horse that we stole the nail from the gravestone of. Because this woman is an asshole. Blair Barnes, age 29. With great effort, she finally managed to push aside the fallen power pole and resume her journey. Still terrified, she stopped in the first gas station to contact the authorities and inform about the disturbing events she had just witnessed. Nothing out of the ordinary was found by the police on that stretch of road. No signs of any crash or the presence of any mysterious kid. The man living in the farm was found a bit drunk, but in good condition. Not a single word was written in any newspaper about the horrors Claire witnessed that night. She went on with her life trying to convince herself that she wasn't crazy after all. That she probably just saw something not meant to be seen. Something in the Twilight Zone. Alright, that was cute. I think that if that was extended to a full-length game, that could actually turn into something really great. As it is, it's kind of just leaving me hungry. That's called Midnight Scenes: The Highway. You have me on mute. Riz, what the fuck, man? Well, yeah, but they found him not looking like we found him. They didn't find any of the corpses either, Lisa. If you enjoyed this short game, please consider supporting my work on Patreon. So, that was quality. That was very quick, but that was quality type of quick. So there's their Patreon if you feel like giving money to them. That's pretty cool. I bet they have all kinds of cool shit. That is patreon.com/pixelshuh, S-H-U-H. Alright, let's move on to the next game. Let's see, we got 1, 2, 3, we got 4 games left to go. So let's keep going up from the bottom. Let's do Safety Blanket Win 32. Remember when 64 and 32-bit games wouldn't work on operating systems that were the opposite? That's not as big of a problem. I mean, 64-bit games still can't work on 32-bit operating systems, obviously. But there's less incompatibility the other way. More compatibility? I guess either is technically correct. Safetyblanket.exe. Alright, that's another one that can't be maximized. There we go. Safety blanket. I kind of want to leave it there just so y'all can see the skull, but I think that'd be annoying. Made for Ludum Dare 29, so this is a quick and dirty game jam game. It's bedtime.
The monsters are out to get you, and your blanket is just too small to cover your entire body. Cover your exposed limbs to fend off the approaching tentacles. So, this is... It's a tentacle game. Is this something... I'm trying to come up with a good joke here, or I'm not just saying lol tentacles, but that's basically all I got. Tentacles will only go for your feet, hands, and head. Oh, okay. I guess this is cute. Wow, this kid tosses and turns. Oh, get away from there, you tentacle. Oh god. I only have to cover up part of the hand or foot. Wow, this is gonna be a while of this shit. No. It's specific parts of the foot. That's weird. Wow, that is a lot of tossing and turning, though. This kid, like, actually maybe needs medical help. No, it's only specific parts of the exposed skin bits. Like, it's the left half of the feet for some reason. Dude, get that creepy grin away from me. Oh no. I'll give that another try again. Get your hand back under the covers. No, stop it. How about I'm just saying these are my good dreams? Yeah, see, it's the left half of each of the items. It's really odd. It's like the hitboxes aren't quite correct. Aw, come on, I'd had that covered. Alright, well that's a game. That exists. That's called Safety Blanket, for anyone who wants to look that up. It's, it exists. So let's move on to... Now, I've been told that Moore's Folly is a little more complicated, so we'll do Midnight Scene. We just did Midnight Scenes. Can we? Yeah, why is there... Oh, Midnight Scenes Data. Okay. Okay, so we've only got two games left to go, so let's try Moore's Folly.
Oh, I hear my chow being grumpy over there. Ah! Alright. There we go. Oh, cool. Now, I've been told that part of this is reading the instructions, which is not that. So we're gonna open up the instruction book. Okay. Well, that's a thing. Technique de Alrone. My name is Dr. Timothy E. Moore, and I'm the man responsible for bringing this monstrosity to the world. Where I originally found the device escapes me now, but I remember stumbling upon it while rummaging in an old secondhand electronics store in some market in some forgotten part of the world. When I inquired, the owner had no recollection of what the thing was or how she had obtained it. I've read enough bad sci-fi to know I should have just left it well alone, but something about it spoke to me. I had to know what was contained within. Collected here are my notes within my singularly unhelpful manual that came with the device. I pray that they can help you more than they ever did me. I should burn them along with this cursed thing, but perhaps it's my arrogance that bides me keep them. I beg you, if you find this, do not research further. Do not be tempted by the device. The technique de Al-Raun, it only brings pain. All rights reserved by Sovereign Corp. Turns into Latin partway through. Up to and including acts of God. Osculator me osculo oris sui quia. Yeah, I don't know what any of that says. Sovereign was like to remind you that by accepting the terms of the EULA, that they do not exist and have never existed and will never exist again. If by participating with the device you find yourself questioning the nature of reality, please discontinue use and sit in silence, never moving, never speaking. 31423, 31424, 31425, all written down there. The first and third crossed out. Be brave, supplicant. Dedication to the device and the creature summoned within is not for the weak of spirit. This kind of reminds me of, like, the Konami instruction books from NES games and Game Boy games back in the 80s and 90s. Specifically the American ones, how they'd always just be full of silly shit like this. No slacking. Keep the device with you at all times. Remember to eat. Carry around sugary foods to help replenish the blood supply. Don't let the ring see you. Poke, poke, poke. These four symbols show up repeatedly. They seem to feed the creature somehow. Or meet some need that keeps them, for lack of a better term, alive. I've taken to calling the symbols blood for obvious reasons. I think my fingertip always be sore, weird. Sometimes strange symbols appear above the creatures. These seem to be harbingers of misfortune. One appears like a small burning flame, another is an upside down crown, which brings none of the creatures. A splatter of ink, blood, or something worse is doomed to repeat over and over again. Fluttering smoke as if from the invisible fire. More to come as I resume my research. Gracious. So this is very complicated. Gracious eyes. Thirsty friends, but very helpful when looking for angelic beings. Uncle Carbuncle. Sensitive and easily stressed out. Don't give him too much responsibility. Blong. That's a good word. What doesn't kill you can still eat you later. Beware of teeth. Helpful words to remember. Mushrooms and 33 times 2 are circled. I find myself staring at the gracious eyes more and more. Alright, we're going to come back to this if we find ourselves... Okay, there's actually not that much left. I find myself staring at the gracious eyes more and more with each passing day. Found two of its secrets, but the last is still eludes me. They stare and blink at me, waiting. The eyes shed tears when I fail them again. I feel as if the answer is on the tip of my tongue, like a haze in my mind that I cannot penetrate. But I know I'm getting close. I feel the gracious eyes praise. I've done it. I know now what the eyes are seeking, and I'm ready to give them what they ask. But woe is me, I cannot gain their audience, for whatever providence has given me this insight, I has also rid me of my previous knowledge, so I once again find myself gripped with madness and despair. Curse this infernal device. I will know its secrets, or I will die trying. Dog park. Cold and unmoving. Do not attempt to look away, or you might never see it again. When you hear the flapping of his wings, sing the song children sing about the grandfather in the sky, the one you see before you cry, or sing it loud and sing it deep, or you might be the next one he keeps. Older and older still, listen for the beat of the wings and know he is coming. The device seems to be physically changing as I delve deeper into its secrets. Strange markings are appearing, burning into the frame of the device as if to signify my progress. I have managed to reveal 3. There appears to be room for at least a dozen or more of the sigils. I've been looking into their meaning in all manners of books and manuscripts and can find nothing. I've tried Sumerian, Norse, Gaelic, several secret societies, Arabic. All have come up with nothing. My next guess is Egyptian, though I have little hope that even the odd numeral system used by the masters of the Nile will shed light on the conundrum. Or you might be the next one he keeps. There once was a boy from Grand Drop who spent his whole day spinning like a top. This is very, very wrong number of syllables. And when he was done, he held his head as he sung, "Please don't make the world stop." Alright, well that's cute. We'll come back to that if we need it. In the meantime, here we are with the puzzle box, which is clearly a Rubik's Cube. Hey there, B, good to see you. I can poke it a little. There's the blood. I guess we draw all 4 symbols. Spins a little. Oh, hi. I'm gonna poke it in the eye. Because it needs to be put out as quickly as possible when there's fire over them. I don't know what that means. I have no idea what I'm doing. Seems a little more nebulous than I tend to like. Seems to be getting angry. I don't see anything that looks like these items on the screen. Oh, abandon hope, ye who enter here. Okay, here's some meters. Alright, that seemed to work. Alright, that did it. I have no idea why, that was just trial and error. Yeah, it's... looks like a Game Boy. Oh god, is this whole thing just gonna be trial and error? Huh. I like how my mouse cursor can go outside of the window. There's probably some kind of logic to this that I'm not seeing. But like I say, I'm not seeing it. Damn it. Steam, get out of here. Alright, turning this one changes the symbol. Turning this one changes also changes the symbol. With no rhyme or reason, seemingly. Your tea is getting cold, okay.
Had some success trying to figure it out with logic. This is as far as I got. Wants me to use the dials to match the sine wave. Well, that's just going to be trial and error again. Just going to be trying out every single thing, because even the ones that look the same are moving at different speeds most of the time. See, that one looks like it should be correct, but they're not matching quite. That one also looks like it should be correct, so I don't know what it wants me to do. Feels like one of those games that would be put out for like a treasure hunt, where it's just nebulous clues that lead to nothing, so that you can find some object in the real world. I guess we found it. Here's some Viking runes. Like trying to figure out government paperwork, right? Looks like it should be correct. What more do you want me to do? And you're doing it for an eldritch monstrosity. And now we're on yet another screen. The meters have changed slightly, and now it says something in maybe Swedish? Kaladesh? Grofrekst Nervort? I don't actually know what language that is. There's a... nothing I can click on, so I guess we just wait on this one. Alright. Anyone remember those fucking symbols? Because I sure as hell don't. God damn it. Seriously? Okay. And escape just closes the game. Fine. It wants me to remember what symbols belong to what buttons. Oh good, it actually does keep this shit here. That one, and two different ones, which I don't think I have. Maybe I do. Is that correct, or was that backwards? Oh, I guess that was right.
The crown summons none of them, I remember it saying. None of these do anything. Clicking on the crown doesn't do anything. Horrors unseen, horrors unheard. All the meters are about empty now. Alright, I think I'm... Now they're all moving toward... Oh, I can drag them around, apparently. Hey, look! Skulls! They're on fire. Also, that tree is chained down, so it can't get away. Have some... Oh, the blood's gone. Here, have that. And... Oh, Let me move the thing. There, eat them. Now we've got a ZF. Okay, bye. We miss you. Oh, I thought I was just gonna walk away. Oh, hey, it's Uncle Carbuncle. Uncle Carbuncle, do you want some blood? Or perhaps an owl? When I click on this one, sometimes it stays black for longer, but I think that's a glitch. Let your fear consume you. Uncle Bedunkle, pretty much. Now I've got 4 runes now. This is what my Game Boy looked like. Your tea is getting cold. Yeah, I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing with Uncle Carbuncle. Nothing seems to do anything. Yeah, nothing seems to be doing anything at all. Click on the blood splats. Nope. Nothing is interactive except the stuff at the bottom. And even that's not doing anything now. Right clicks don't work. So what, do I restart the game maybe? Oh, meters are running low now. The ringing bell commands you. Let's see if it'll try and jump scare me again. Yes, I see that. Those are the same runes we already had. Now it wants me to wait through the hourglass again. Joy. Just what I wanted. A game where you sit and wait. So how are you guys doing? This has been a weird night, right? The window seems to move around on its own too, which is kind of strange. So that's 4411. We don't have that last symbol. Do we? No, we don't. Now we're back here. Which seems to be what happens when you put in an incorrect pattern. Alright.
1-1. We don't have those symbols. I don't know what it wants me to do. I'm completely baffled by what it's trying to tell me. Ugh. Also, Alt-F4 now doesn't work. So that's fun. Alt-F4 was working before to close it. It has this awful habit of moving the title bar off the top of the screen. And it's moving the window around very slowly, I think, because it starts out like this just fine, and then I look back and I realize it's off-center. It's really odd. I have no idea what it wants me to do, because it's drawing symbols I have no way of drawing back. And just about everything leads me there. Four goats when the moon's a lion. Alt, erase progress, escape to quit. Yeah, Midnight Scenes was like the very intro to a game, rather than a whole game. First to it shows you are the king symbol. Yes, sometimes. Shows me the owl here. And then this symbol, and this symbol I can't draw. And it's... apparently, when I hit Alt F4, it counted as Alt. To erase my progress immediately without asking me. So, I think I'm done. This is kind of a confusing mess, and it just seems to be more... functionally, it seems to be more about brute forcing the puzzles than actually solving them. So, I don't know. That's definitely not my thing. If you want to try and decode it, it's called Moore's Folly. M-O-O-R-E-S space F-O-L-L-Y. Definitely not my thing. Cute idea, I guess, but I don't think it was executed in a way that I find remotely interesting. So, our last game, and this is the only one that my wife didn't get for me. She got all the rest of these. Thank you, sweetie. I've actually enjoyed the majority of these. That was the only one that actually kind of actively made me irritated. Even the bad ones I've enjoyed. The hair in the wall was kind of incredible for how bad it was. This last one I actually got myself. It's called Freedom Diegesis. And it is a thing. This is the only one I'm not going in blind on. I don't know how long I'll play it. But it's got some cool ideas. And it's pretty fucking spooky. If it'll start up. Oh, we got a hourglass on the mouse cursor. That's a good sign. Here we go, Freedom Diegesis. Alright, looks like we're gonna need window capture because that is a tiny fucking window. I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to use that to play because that is hard to look at. There we go, got a good window capture. It is at a weird aspect ratio too. It's just short of 16:9. See that? That's bizarre. Can't see shit, Captain. Okay, I might not even be able to play this. It does look a little ski-free, doesn't it? Holy shit! How is anyone expected to look at this? Like, I may have a solution. I don't think so, though. Probably stuck at that particular aspect ratio. One sec. Where is my... What? It says W to resize. I can't even read that.
Yeah.
W. Okay, that put it in full screen. That will work. Thank you, sweetie. And it's being very unhelpful. One sec. There we go. Okay. Okay. Let's try. Start up the game, which starts up very slowly, unfortunately. Yeah, it was very... It's got a weird black border around it. Can't do much about that. Alright, let's make it not blurry. Ooh, that's nice. Window capture... Transformation... Size... 1920 by 1080... That's wrong. 900, 1600, there we go. Now I think we can all see it. That good for everyone? All right, so M was mute all audio, which I think is what I did a second ago. All right, start game. Introduction, the Western Kingdom. O fallen warrior, the kingdom needs you now more than ever. Please watch over me from above. That is Princess Remedea. Oh no, she was stolen by an ant. Honored warriors, wow, he is quite large. This is a dark time for our kingdom. Who will brave the eastern lands to rescue my daughter from those perverted savages? And that is clearly Toad. And Luigi. And Pauline. No, not for us. That place is fucked up. Sorry, dude. Come with me, prisoner. Disgraced prisoner, bring my stolen daughter home and I will grant you your freedom. Idea, Mario cosplaying as Luigi. I mean, that's what Player 2 is in a lot of the old ones. I know now that you will never rescue me. World 1, the Eastern Lands. Ba 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 da da da. What the fuck? Okay, here's my controls. Alright. I don't know how to jump. X is jump. Alright. I got the coin. Does this look familiar yet? Oh no. I am the dead. Alright, let's try that again. This time without dying. The controls are really sluggish, by the way. I did not realize quite how sluggish they were gonna be. Here we go. Like, there's not a delay on the individual controls, it just feels like you're dragging your ass through it. A quiet shore. You got a poison mushroom. Oh, okay. Now that brick is electrified. Yes, I suppose death is one path to freedom. Try again. Now this game is atmospheric as fuck, as you might notice. Mario is impaled on that flagpole. I suppose death is one path to freedom is the slogan of my presidential campaign. Something wicked. This is one of those games where you can absolutely get stuck, so they provide you with a suicide button. Trick says, take it from me, treasure isn't worth the risk. Yeah, that sounds like a bet. I got the teddy bear. Hooray! These colored beasts all react differently. I think yellow you can't jump on, while purple you can stand on. There must be some way to get across the spikes. Press C to lift objects, which in this case means this dude. He can stand on me too, that's fun. Blue is a friendly oh god! I mean, I meant to do that. Internet's dying, I'm sorry. I hope it gets better. Ours was dying earlier, it seems to be pretty okay now. Ghost around after you die. I don't think so now. Treasures are optional. Just like real life. Yeah, you can't pick up the purple ones. Whoops. Okay, there we go. Fuck! Fuck! You have to be right... I guess you can move to his right side and that'll help. Yeah, you can't move your ghost around after dying. There we go. Checkpointing seems to be all at the beginning and end of the stage. So, not a lot of it. There we go. Now the good part. Wah-ah-ah-ah. Get out of here. Thank you.
I think the words you're looking for are, Jesus Christ, how horrifying. Alright, should be able to still ride on him, yeah. As far as I know, there's not a way to get that treasure and survive. So, oh well, we're not going for completionist anyway. 1-3, Village Shrines. What's down here, anyway? Oh, okay. There we go. That one. Exactly. This is happening and it's fine. There's nothing wrong at all. Fuck. Alright, we can move this one around. That's a ladder. That's the mast. There's another one of those infinity coins. This door's locking mechanism is rusted shut. Okay. He can jump. You really thought we were done with Lisa and its grotesque exploits. Oh hey, the block stayed in the same position, so that's a nice touch. Huh, I wonder if I can get up to that Goomba. I mean that totally unique creature that's definitely not ripped off of anything else. I can, but it doesn't do me a lot of good. I don't know what breaking this purple goop does, but, there we are. Breaking the purple goop. Oh, I see. Not sure what the point of that is, though. We gotta get around to that TNT. I have no idea how to get past this guy. Let's see if he jumps. Nope. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do there. Yeah, it does look very Lisa. Alright, we're gonna give this a couple more tries. Anyone else have any ideas as to how to get past that guy? Exactly, the AI can jump, we're fucked now. There's a Sniffit mask. A Shy Guy mask, I suppose, since it doesn't have the protruding mouth. Oh, maybe we're supposed to get him to run into the fire. Well, that sort of worked. Trick's corpse says, find another way to get through. Well, I'm glad the corpse can still talk. That looks dangerous. Don't you drop that shit on me. It's dangerous to play with fire. Try it. Well, he's dead. And so am I. Well, now we know sort of what we're doing. Kinda wanna see if we can get the swordsman to run into the fire. Though I doubt it. I think he'll catch up before he can get that far. Oh, I was wrong. Haha, it worked. Alright, well, he's dead now. I can't believe he's fucking dead. As to where I'm supposed to drop that TNT. No way to put out the fires that I can see. Do I need this guy for something? Seems like I should need this guy for something, doesn't it? Tablet says everything in its right place. Here, just drop down there, you're fine. To reset the level, but not yourself. Interesting. Can't pick up the TNT. I don't know how to get fire. Okay, this looks like a pretty complicated puzzle. Well, I actually think that's about it for now. I did not realize how tired I'd be getting going through this many games in a row. And we've hit the 2-hour mark. So now I know about the length that we can make these streams. And I think this works out very well. I hope you've all been enjoying yourselves. I certainly have. I love new and interesting game ideas, and I love playing bad games too, as long as they're not boring bad. So, I've been having a pretty fucking good time here. This has been the inaugural episode of Press Any Key, and I've enjoyed myself a lot. I'm gonna try and do this once a month. If you guys have any games or categories of games, you know, subject matter, this was, this month all the games found were from searching for spooky, scary, or skeletons. So, you know, very fitting for the Friday the 12th. So if you guys have any suggestions for other games to try playing, give me a shout. For the most part, we can keep putting together these collections on our own, I think. Christy did an excellent job tonight, so say thank you to my wife for setting this whole thing up for us. and say thank you to me for being awesome.
If y'all aren't following, we've got a follow button. If you want to subscribe, it's $5 and you get a cool truck emote. Never necessary, but always appreciated. For those that want to know about this game, it is called Freedom Diegesis. Let me get you the... How is that spelled? F-R-E-E, well, freedom, obviously. And diegesis is D-I-E-G-E-S-I-S. I'm pretty sure I know what that word means, but it's not coming to me at the moment. Schedule for the next week is looking like the following. Tomorrow morning, Christy will be doing her regular art stream, making thumbnails for YouTube videos. Sunday night will be my eldest sister, Sue, playing Styx, which is the stealth game about the goblin that says fuck. The next game, Monday, Christy will be playing No One Lives Forever, which is a cool shooter about spies. It's a bit of a comedy. It's very fun and lighthearted compared to... say Daniel Craig's James Bond, but then again, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest is lighthearted compared to Daniel Craig's James Bond. Tuesday will be Andrea finishing up the Sexy Brutale puzzle game about using time travel to prevent murders. Wednesday will be our day one Jackbox 5 stream for Community Night, Friends Day Wednesday. I really hope that you will all join us for that because that's going to be amazing. We have been provided an advance key by our friend Alvaro, who is OMG ta awesome in the chat. Not here right now, but often is. And that's just going to be friggin' great. Thursday will be Alice playing, I think more LEGO Dimensions. I think she's doing Final Fantasy on the fourth Thursday of each month. So I think next week is going to be more LEGO Dimensions. And finally, Friday will be back around to me and I'll be starting on Sam & Max Season 3, The Devil's Playground. And, well, you guys know that's a blast. So thanks again, everyone, for coming. It has been great, and I'm glad this was a relative success, and I hope you guys will keep coming back around for our streams. Good night, everyone. Take care of yourselves.